Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you in this video lecture on the solution and discussion on gate question papers in mechanical engineering subject. So this is lecture number 29 on the gate question paper discussion, and the subject here is refrigeration. So we are continuing with the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture also we discussed the refrigeration, and we continue here with a few more questions on the refrigeration. And this is the question from 2014 question paper. A heat pump with refrigerant R12 is used for space heating between temperature limits of -20°C and 25°C. The heat record is 200 megajoules per hour. Assume the specific heat of vapor at the time of discharge as 0.98 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Other relevant properties are given below in the table. The enthalpy in kilojoules per kilogram of the refrigerant at isentropic compressor discharge is dash. So we have to calculate the compressor discharge enthalpy. So we are given the properties here. So the pressure -20°C, which is evaporator temperature, 25°C, which is the condenser temperature, and the enthalpy, entropy, specific entropy properties are given in the table. Now the answer is 433.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So the enthalpy at the outlet of the compressor is 433.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So we will see how. So the diagram, temperature entropy diagram for the refrigeration cycle, vapor compression refrigeration cycle is shown here. So 1 to 2 is the evaporator, 2 to 3 is the compressor process, 3 to 4 is the condenser. So the compressor inlet is entropy S2, compressor outlet entropy S3. So to find the temperature at T3, we have to take the condition S2 equal to S3. So S2 is the saturated vapor, so SG2 equal to SG3. Plus Cp into logarithmic of T3 by T3s. So T3 by T3s or T3 dash. So the value given 1.7841 SG2. So for the given evaporator temperature, SG2 equal to 1.7841. So for the given condenser temperature, SG3 equal to 1.7183 plus 0.98. So the specific heat of vapor is 0.98 in logarithmic of T3 divided by 25 plus 273. So taking the rearranging the term, logarithmic of T3 by 25 plus 273 equal to 1.7841 minus 1.7183 divided by 0.98, which is 0.067414, and taking the anti-logarithm and calculating T3 equal to 318.7 Kelvin. So the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant at the end of the compression process, H3 equal to HG3 plus Cp into T3 minus T3S, which is 413.02, which is HG3 plus 0.98 into 318.7 minus 298 equal to 433.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So that is the answer for the problem. The specific enthalpy of the refrigerant at the discharge of the compressor is 433.3 kilojoules per kilogram. The next question is from 2015 question paper. The refrigerant vapor enters into the compressor of a standard vapor compression cycle is at -10°C, where the enthalpy is 402 kilojoules per kilogram, and leaves the compressor at 50°C, where the enthalpy is 432 kilojoules per kilogram. It leaves the condenser at 30°C, where the enthalpy is 237 kilojoules per kilogram. So COP of the cycle is dash. So this is the vapor compression cycle for the given condition. It is a standard vapor compression cycle. And the, what is standard vapor compression cycle, that you have to understand. So the standard vapor compression cycle or simple vapor compression cycle, at the entry of the compressor, it is disaturated vapor, and at the outlet of the condenser, it is saturated liquid. So these are all the two conditions. Entry of the compressor, saturated vapor. Outlet of the condenser, 4, it is saturated liquid. That is what standard or simple vapor compression refrigeration cycle. And the value given, so the data given here, the specific enthalpy at the inlet of the compressor, H2 equal to 402 kilojoules per kilogram. The specific enthalpy at the outlet of the compressor, H3 equal to 432 kilojoules per kilogram. The specific enthalpy at the outlet of the condenser H1 equal to H4 equal to 237 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the COP equal to H2 minus H1 divided by H3 minus H2. So calculating 402 minus 237 divided by 432 minus 402 equal to 5.5. So the COP of the cycle is 5.5. That is the answer to the problem. The next question is from 2016 question paper. A refrigerator uses R134a as its refrigerant and operates on an ideal vapor compression refrigerant cycle between 0.14 MPa and 0.8 MPa pressure. If the mass flow rate of the refrigerant is 0.05 kg per second, the rate of heat rejection to the environment is dash kilowatts. So the given data here, so the at P equal to 0.14 MPa, enthalpy is 236.04 kilojoules per kilogram and entropy is 0.9322 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. At P equal to 0.8 MPa, H enthalpy equal to specific enthalpy equal to 272.05 kilojoules per kilogram and superheated, it is a superheated vapor. At a pressure 0.8 MPa, enthalpy H equal to 93.42 kilojoules per kilogram, it is saturated liquid. So this is the vapor compression refrigeration cycle and the data are given in the problem. Now we have to calculate the rate of heat rejection to the environment. So the heat rejection is taking place between the process 3 and 4, it is condenser process. So for the condenser, heat rejected to the environment, that is heat equal to heat rejected in the condenser. So mass of the refrigerant into H3 minus H4. So mass of the refrigerant is 0.05. Enthalpy H3 equal to at the entrance of the condenser it is superheated vapor. So 272.05 minus at the outlet of the condenser it is saturated liquid. So this is 93.42. So calculating, so the heat rejected equal to 8.9315 kilojoules per second. So the answer is 8.9315 kilowatts or kilojoules per second. The next question is from 2016 question paper. In a vapor compression cycle shown in the figure, the evaporating and condensing temperatures are 260 Kelvin and 310 Kelvin respectively. The compressor takes in liquid vapor mixture at a state 1 and isentropically compresses it to a dry saturated vapor condition state 2. The specific heat of the liquid refrigerant is 4.8 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and may be treated as constant. The enthalpy of evaporation of the refrigerant at 310 Kelvin. So the enthalpy of evaporation is H2 minus H3. So this is 1054 kilojoules per kilogram. The difference between enthalpies at the state point 1 and 0. So 0 is here, saturated liquid. So 1 and 0 is dash kilojoules per kilogram. So we have to calculate the enthalpy difference between H1 and H2O. That is the question. And the answer here is 1103.5 kilojoules per kilogram. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the diagram given here. So the 260 Kelvin evaporator temperature, 310 Kelvin condenser temperature, and we draw a vertical line from 3. So 3 dash is vertical line, which is equal to 1 2. Now H2 minus H3 is given in the problem. H2 minus H3 is the enthalpy of evaporation at 310 Kelvin, which is 1054 kilojoules per kilogram. So the entropy change between S2 and S3. So 2 and 3, the entropy change, S2 minus H3 equal to H2 minus H3 divided by T2. So dS equal to del Q by T. So the heat transfer is enthalpy change divided by the temperature. So 1054 divided by 310 equal to 3.4 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now S2 minus S3, look at the diagram. S2 minus S3 equal to S1 minus S3 dash. So this is a rectangle. 1, 2, 3, 3 dash is a rectangle. So S2 minus S3 equal to S1 minus S3 dash. Now we calculate S3 minus SO. So S3 minus SO is equal to S3 dash minus SO. So because S3 equal to S3 dash. So the S3 dash minus SO equal to Cp into logarithmic of T3 by TO. So T3 is the temperature here divided by TO. So 4.8 into logarithmic of 310 by 260 equal to 0.8442 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now we have to calculate S1 minus SO. So S1 minus SO equal to S1 minus S3 dash plus S3 dash minus SO. So S1 minus S3 dash. So S1 minus S3 dash we have calculated here. So this is equal to 3.4 and S3 minus SO equal to S3 dash minus SO equal to 0.8442. So adding these two, the S1 minus SO equal to 4.2442 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now H1 minus HO equal to T1 into S1 minus SO. So H1 minus HO equal to T1 into S1 minus SO. So T1 equal to 260 Kelvin into 4.2442 equal to 1103.5 kilojoules per kilogram. So this is the answer. The enthalpy difference between H1 and HO. So H1 is the wet vapor of the refrigerant. HO is the saturated liquid of the refrigerant at the temperature 260 Kelvin. The next question is from 2018 question paper. A standard vapor compression refrigeration cycle operating with the condensing temperature of 35 degrees Celsius and the evaporating temperature of minus 10 degrees Celsius develops 15 kilowatt of cooling. The pH diagram is shown in the figure. If the isentropic efficiency of the compressor is 0.75 and the magnitude of the compressor power in kilowatt is dash. So correct to 2 decimal point. So the pressure enthalpy diagram shown here. And the enthalpy at different points are also shown. So this is the outlet of the compressor, inlet of the compressor, inlet of the evaporator. Everything is given. So the pressure limit is also given here. The temperature is minus 10 degrees Celsius evaporator temperature and the condenser temperature is 35 degrees Celsius. So this diagram is given in the question paper. Now the refrigeration effect equal to M into enthalpy change across the evaporator. So what is evaporator outlet? Evaporator outlet enthalpy is 400, evaporator inlet temperature, inlet enthalpy is 250. So M into 400 minus 250 equal to 15 kilowatts. That is the cooling effect produced by the refrigerator. So calculating the mass of the refrigerant equal to 0.1 kilograms per second. Now we have to calculate the compressor power. So compressor power equal to M into the enthalpy change across the compressor. So enthalpy change across the compressor is 475 minus 400. So this line, the curved line is the compression process. So 475 the enthalpy at the outlet of the compressor, 400 is the enthalpy at the inlet of the compressor. So 475 minus 400 divided by the given efficiency of the compressor. So the compressor power equal to 0.1 into 75 divided by 0.75 equal to 10 kilowatts. So the calculator is not required here to solve the problem. Please understand. So the answer is 10 kilowatts. The next question is from 1997 question paper. In a standard vapor compression refrigeration cycle operating between evaporator temperature of minus 10 degrees Celsius and condenser temperature of 40 degrees Celsius, the enthalpy of the refrigerant free on 12 at the end of compression is 220 kilojoules per kilogram. Show the cycle on the TS plane, calculate the COP of the cycle, the refrigeration capacity and compressor power assuming a refrigerant flow rate of 1 kilogram per minute. You may use the extract of the Freon 12 property table given below. So the properties are given. So condenser temperature 40 degrees Celsius, evaporator temperature minus 10 degrees Celsius. We are given the pressure, saturation pressure, enthalpy of the liquid, enthalpy of the vapor. So everything is given. Now we have to solve the problem. There are two questions. First question is COP of the cycle. The second question is refrigeration capacity and the compressor power. So we have to solve the problem. So this is a 5 mark question. So the given data, mass of the refrigerant M equal to 1 kilogram per minute, which is 0.017 kilograms per second. Evaporator temperature is minus 10 degrees Celsius. Condenser temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. So this is the temperature entropy diagram of the standard vapor compression cycle. So what is standard vapor compression cycle? Inlet of the compressor is saturated vapor. Outlet of the condenser is saturated liquid. So outlet of this compressor is the superheated vapor. Now, the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant after compression, it is given in the problem, 220 kilojoules per kilogram. The specific enthalpy of the refrigerant after evaporation, H2 equal to HG2 equal to 183.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant before evaporation, H1 equal to H4. So, for 4 to 1 process, enthalpy remains constant. So, it is throttling process. So, HO4 equal to 74.53 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, we have to calculate COP, coefficient of performance, COP equal to H2 minus H1 divided by H3 minus H2, which is 183.1 minus 74.53 divided by 220 minus 183.1 equal to 2.94. The refrigeration capacity, so M into H2 minus H1, so M into mass of the refrigerant into enthalpy change across the evaporator, so 0.017 into 183.1 minus 74.53 equal to 1.84 kilojoules per second, and power required to drive the compressor, so the power equal to mass into H3 minus H2, so enthalpy change across the compressor, so 0.017 into 220 minus 183.1 equal to 0.63 kilowatts. So these are all the answers. COP equal to 2.94, refrigeration capacity or refrigeration effect equal to 1.84 kilojoules per second, and the power required to drive the compressor is 0.63 kilowatts. The next question is from 2002 question paper. An ice making plant using refrigerant R12 is having an evaporator saturation temperature of 25 degrees Celsius and the condenser saturation temperature of 35 degrees Celsius. The vapor is leaving the compressor at 65 degrees Celsius. Following table shows the properties of the refrigerant. So we are given the condenser evaporator temperature 25 degrees Celsius. All the properties are given here. Saturation, enthalpy, liquid and vapor are shown here. And the condenser temperature is 35 degrees Celsius. And the properties are given here. And the enthalpy of the superheated refrigerant at 850 kilopascal and 65 degrees Celsius is 225.5 kilojoules per kilogram. So the outlet of the superheater, outlet of the compressor. So it is also superheated refrigerant. So calculate the coefficient of performance of the system. If the capacity of the plant is 5 kilowatt, calculate the mass flow rate of the refrigerant and power consumption. So we have to calculate COP, mass flow rate of the refrigerant and the power of the compressor, power required to drive the compressor. So we write down the given data. Condenser temperature is 35 degrees Celsius. Evaporator temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. Temperature at the end of the compression is T3 equal to 65 degrees Celsius. And the refrigeration capacity Q equal to heat rejected equal to 5 kilowatt. And this is the vapor compression refrigeration cycle for the problem. And the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant after compression, H3 equal to 225.5 kilojoules per kilogram. It is given there in the table. And the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant before evaporation, H4 equal to HO4, which is 69.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant before compression, H2 equal to HG2 equal to 176.5 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, the coefficient of performance, COP equal to H2 minus H1, refrigeration effect, divided by H3 minus H2, the power required to drive the compressor. So, 176.5. Minus 69.6 divided by 225.5 minus 176.5 equal to 2.18. And the mass of the refrigerant, M equal to refrigeration effect or heat extracted divided by H2 minus H1. So the refrigeration effect is given as 5 kilowatts. So 5 divided by 176.5 minus 69.6 equal to 0.04677 kilograms per second. And the power required to drive the compressor, P equal to M into H3 minus H2, which is 0.04677 into 225.5 minus 176.5 equal to 2.29 kilowatts. So these are all the answers. COP we calculated, mass equal to 0.04677 kilograms per second, and the power of the compressor is 2.29 kilowatts. And this is from 2002 question paper. The answers are given here. So, coefficient of performance 2.18, mass flow rate is 0.04677 kilograms per second, and power consumption is 2.29 kilowatts. The next question is from 1987 question paper. A reciprocating compressor produces 10 tons of refrigeration at an evaporator temperature of 5 degrees Celsius and condenser temperature of 35 degrees Celsius. Estimate how much cooling effect it can produce at an evaporator temperature of minus 30 degrees Celsius and the condenser temperature remains unaltered. So given R12 refrigerant, clearance ratio, clearance is 5%, index of compression is 1.15, extract from the refrigeration table, the properties are given. So minus 30 degrees Celsius, the properties are given, specific volume, enthalpy are given, 5 degrees Celsius and 35 degrees Celsius. So 35 degrees Celsius is the condenser temperature. There are two evaporator temperature. First, initially it is operating with 5 degrees Celsius. Later on it is altered to minus 30 degrees Celsius. Now you have to calculate the effect of the cooling effect produced when the evaporator temperature is altered. So refrigeration effect equal to 10 tons. So 10 into 3.5 equal to 35 kilojoules per second. And this is the refrigeration cycle. And for when the condenser temperature is 35 degrees Celsius and evaporator temperature is 5 degrees Celsius. So initial first state of first condition of the problem, we calculate the specific enthalpy of the evaporator. At the evaporator outlet is H2 equal to 190.88 kilojoules per kilogram. Specific enthalpy at the evaporator inlet, H1 equal to HFO equal to 16.74 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the mass of the refrigerant equal to M into, so refrigeration effect equal to M into H2 minus H1. So substituting 35 equal to M into 190.88 minus 69.74. So solving for this equation, M equal to 0.2889 kilograms per second. Now the altering the evaporator temperature. So the condenser temperature, there is no change, 35 degrees Celsius, and the evaporator temperature is altered to minus 30 degrees Celsius. Now the specific enthalpy at the evaporator outlet is 174.96 kilojoules per kilogram, and the specific enthalpy at the evaporator inlet, H1 equal to HFO equal to 16.74 kilojoules per kilogram. So there is no change in the H1 value, only the H2 value is changing. And refrigeration effect, RE equal to M into H2 minus H1. So mass we have calculated from the earlier condition. So refrigeration effect equal to 0.2889 into 174.96 minus 69.74 equal to 30.4 kilojoules per second. So this is the answer to the problem. So the refrigeration effect for the modified condition is 30.4 kilojoules per second. And we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering. You can refer to it. I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the solution to the gate question paper. Also the video lectures on all the subjects mentioned in the shown here. So you can subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better preparation and pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. So you please post your comments on the comments box. You subscribe the channel and you may write to my email ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video in the solution on gate question paper.